problem.
Does that mean sunbathe?
That's correct. And the disease that occurs from not getting enough light is called malillumination. It's a serious problem. And even white people suffer from malillumination. They call it seasonal affective disorder. It causes them to be depressed and that kind of thing. But it goes into a much more serious problem for melanin-dominant individuals because our brain requires that it be exposed to full-spectrum light. Otherwise, we have severe personality disorders. We have severe changes in what would appear to be normal behavior because of lack of light. So just being under fluorescent lights and incandescent lights is inadequate for a melanin-dominant individual. They must have full-spectrum light exposure.
So, Jewel, you're telling me as an editor, I spend most of my time in a dark room with just TV monitors.
And it's a problem for you.
And I live in New England, and...
It's a problem for you.
There's no sun up here.
It's a big problem for him.
And this is the reason why I'm in beautiful... This is the reason why I'm in beautiful Atlanta, Georgia.
So you're saying I need to move to closer to the equator so I can get more sunlight,
or you need to make sure that you take time out and go someplace like that. For me to stay in Michigan the last 9 years that I was there, I had to go every winter to the tropics for at least 10 to 12 days and actually charge up my battery,
regenerate,
my melanocytes,
mm-hmm,
so that I could get through the rest of their early spring and winter.
Okay, so sunlight's a beginning. Get more sunlight, move out of New England. We have winter 8-12 months a year. You might as well, okay, I won't say 10 months a year we have winter. There's very little sunlight, so I need to move out. What else can I do as a black person in this New England region? What kind of diet should I maintain?
One that is definitely living. That is to say, not a lot of cooked food until in the winter. And if you're going to cook, it should be whole grains and beans. That should be the primary foods along with vegetables in season. But raw vegetables are very, very important for us because it contains the light we need. We need to have fresh water. We do not need adulterated carbohydrates in the form of sugars. Too much fruit juice is very deleterious to the minerals that are needed to store the light. See, the melanin, once it absorbs the light, you want to store it like a battery. That's why if you don't have that battery acid, which is minerals, the charge will pass through, but then it doesn't hold, and then you can't go back later and actually quick start the system.
So you
have to have those minerals on board when you sunbathe so that the melanin is charged up and then the excess energy is stored in the mineral so that when you're not in sunlight, you won't know it because the stored minerals will kick in the system and you'll still function properly.
As you can tell, 2-second delay for a CD.
So how is it that you deal with dis-ease?
How is it that we deal with
dis-ease? Disease.
Well, dis-ease is an energy imbalance. That's all it is. And so, therefore, now we can apply all different modalities to bring about balance and harmony again. That's why using light, you know, for the longest time, my colleagues wanted to say that that was quackery to actually use light to treat an individual and that they would have taken your license and did do that to many of my future-sighted, truth-aligned colleagues as I read their work, that mm-hmm. they were totally, you know, blasted and discredited, etc.
Well,
and now we have a whole science in medicine known as phototherapy.
Well, you were upsetting the status quo with that thought process. It wasn't published in the science journals and touted by the pharmaceutical companies and something that the insurance company could bill for.
Etc. And so that's true. And so now they will pay for some of these things. There's still a lot more that can be done. So therefore, if we wanted to try to charge up the system and bring it into balance with a pill, then how could we then charge you for exposure to light? So not until we could get it all together and put it in a form that we could charge for, then could we give it to you. And see, and this is why I'm very upset about the fact that the scientific literature has proclaimed and explained techniques for healing that supersede the consciousness of the general public by almost 30 to 40 years.
While you were talking, we took a phone call off the air from an AIDS researcher, a proclaimed scientist in the Brookline area, and he didn't listen to the entire program, but the little that he heard, I guess he was beginning to take some difference with what you were saying about the electromagnetic spectrum and the nature of it, what it is, and wanted to put in that radio waves were equating them to sound waves, and they were not. They were different. It was mechanical waves versus subatomic photons. So he wanted that to be registered and get a reaction from you on that.
Well, there's nothing to react about, but as I look here, with radio waves, all light particles are subatomic photons. Depends on what level of their anatomy or understanding the atom, which is what the word anatomy comes from, that you look at. So if we actually wanted to look at one ear of corn, for example, in a field of corn, and in a human body that is structurally in alignment with its nervous system, can perceive that as a reality and then identify a source of which it can then share it with other people. And the Dogons, for example, use their clothing, use ceremonial ointment, ornaments, etc., straight these star systems that they were perceiving without a telescope.
And the Dogon people are located in West Africa in the country of Mali.
Correct.
He also wanted to express the notion of making distinctions between the races, that scientifically is not true.
And that scientifically is not true. And so he needs to do more work. I just bought, maybe about 4 years ago, more studying. I just bought 4 years ago a volume, a three-set volume. It cost me $650 because the scientists that have done nothing but dedicated their lives to studying melanin come together and publish every 4 years.
So
if you're not a member of a clan, then you have to pay for it. It's $650. And it was interesting because most of the contributors and researchers were from universities or from countries where most of the people were melanin recessive. And one of the things that's what I thought was very interesting. So obviously the specimens that they used for their research didn't come from them. It had to come from people who were melanin dominant.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the things that I found in those volumes, and these are the last volume, when they talked about the melanoopiotrophic molecule, that's how they refer to it.
Okay. Opiotrophic.
That's correct, because part of the structure of melanin is exactly like the opiate drugs. It's almost like a cousin, which is one of the reasons why melanin-dominant individuals who participate in the misuse of opiate drugs have a very hard time detoxing from it, because the melanin molecule absorbs it and attaches to it, thinking that it's part of itself. So they discovered and recognized that wherever melanin was placed on a petri dish with a virus, and especially the HIV virus, virus could not grow. And in the book, they talked about the fact that this was very exciting because melanin was one of the new drugs that was going to be looked at as a treatment for HIV and virulent viral diseases.
Now, it's interesting because the fellow that called, it was an AIDS researcher, and he was very much interested in the differences between people. I don't know that he got that far with his research with melanin, but I do remember when Richard King was a guest on Black Talk, he talked about the inability or the difficulty it is for melanin-dominant people to kick the habit, if you will, of those opiate drugs.
Because it's because the melanin molecule reads it as part of itself and binds to it. And so if the drug rehab programs do not have within the program a protocol that splices the opiate off of the melanin molecule, these individuals have an extremely high recidivism rate. And to this day, I don't know any publicly funded programs that have looked at nutrition that is necessary for the melanin-dominant individual and has supplied them with the chelators, because you use a chelator to actually cut that off, that will actually then allow that to be excreted through the kidneys or liver out of the system so these individuals can be free.
And a chelator is what?
A chelator is a substance that actually binds, based on the molecular charge, to another compound, making it now have a neutral effect in the system where it can actually be eliminated.
So let me just go back a little bit. You made the distinction.